हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन फॉर द लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इन द चैप्टर 4 फ्रैक्शन. ओके, इन द एक्सरसाइज 7 वी हैव लर्न सम एग्जांपल्स बेस्ड ऑन द फ्रैक्शन. हियर ऑल्सो नेक्स्ट अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस एक्सरसाइज 8, इन विच वी हैव टू डील विद द कंपेरिजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. After that, addition, subtraction of fraction and the word problems based on the concept of fraction. Okay, so just pay attention and understand the concept. All these examples, the examples which will be asked in the Ganit Pravinya, all are based on the depth of concept. Okay, so once you understand the concept, you can solve by any method. It will not be asked that you have to go by any particular method. You can solve by your own method, but that method should be according to the rule of maths or rule of that concept. Okay, so understand the concept. Okay, see the first question in the exercise 8. Open your book, exercise 8, first question. Put your finger, I am reading the instruction, put your finger. Question 1 is, which is the smallest of the fractions? Means here, see, some fractions are given: 47 upon 31, 47 upon 34, 47 upon 51, 47 upon 65, and 47 upon 48. So out of these fractions, which is the smallest? In regular maths, we have learned the comparison of fraction, that is greater than, smaller than, and equal to, or ascending and descending order of the fraction. Two types of fraction we have seen, comparison of two types of fraction, when denominators are same and when numerators are same. So these fractions are having numerators same. These fractions are, these are such fractions whose numerators are same. Okay, so in that case, when numerators are same, which fraction is smallest or which fraction is greatest? Can you tell me, when numerators are same? See, when denominators are same, 4 upon 4 by 8 and 3 by 8. Denominators are same, in that case, whose numerator is smaller, that fraction is smaller. Okay? And whose numerator is greater, that fraction will be greater. But when numerators are same, in that case, opposite of this, now here we have to find smallest fraction. So which will be the smallest fraction? Whose denominator will be greatest. Whose denominator will be greatest, that will be your smallest fraction. So here in this, which is the greatest denominator? 65. So this fraction, 47 upon 65, is the smallest fraction. Okay? See, when denominators are same, as usual, whose numerator is small, that fraction is smaller. Okay, but when numerators are same, in that case, the fraction having greatest denominator, that fraction is smallest actually. Okay, so here, which is the smallest one? 47 upon 65. Is the smallest. Okay, then second, which of the following fraction is the largest. So see here, 25 upon 75, 6 upon 12, 9 upon 27, 8 upon 24. Out of these four fractions, which is the largest, biggest, that we have to find. Now see, if you observe these fractions, these fractions don't have same denominator or same numerator. Their denominator and numerators are different. So what to do? Okay, see here, if you observe these fractions, you will come to know that this numerator and denominator are divisible by any common number. That means what, you know, we can reduce these fractions into lowest term. smallest term. Okay, as we have done in yesterday's exercise, we can reduce this, we can make less, we can find the smallest term of this. How to find? See now, 25 and 75. Think that both 25 and 75 are divisible by which number? Which greatest number? Or see here, if you see 25 and 75, both are divisible by which number? 25. So if you divide 25 and 75, 25 upon 75, divide by 25, because 25 is divisible by 25 and 75 is also divisible by 75. Okay, so 25 ones are 25, 25 threes are 75. 1/3, 1 upon 3, 1/3 is the smallest term of this 25 upon 75. Okay, then 6 upon 12, both are divisible by which number? Both are divisible by 6. Divide by 6, that is 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 1 by 2. Okay, again 9 upon 27, 9 and 27 both are divisible by 9, correct? 9 ones are 9, 9 threes are 27. Then 8 upon 24, both are divisible by, both numerator and denominator are divisible by 8. 8 ones are 8, 8 threes are 24. So when we found the lowest term or reduced form of all these fractions, we got 1 upon 3, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3. Now if you will see, observe these fractions, their numerators are same, that is 1. So now we can compare which fraction is largest. Okay, so when numerators are same, the fraction having lowest denominator is biggest fraction. So in this, which fraction has lowest denominator? 3 2 3 3 2, right? 2, this 1 by 2 has lowest denominator, smallest denominator. That means 1 by 2 is the largest fraction. So 1 by 2 is the largest. Understood? Next, third one, 12 upon 48, 21 upon 63, 9 upon 45, 27 upon 36. Let's read the instruction. What is the question for this? Which is the smallest of the fraction? So out of these four, we have to find out smallest fraction. Okay, so 12 upon again, if you will observe these fractions, they don't have same denominator or same numerator. Then we have to go by this method. We have to find their reduced form, smallest term. For that, what we will do, as we have done there, both 12 and 48 are divisible by which same number? See, 12 is in table of 12 and 48 is also in table of 12, so they are divisible by 12. That is, 12 ones are 12, 4s are 48. Okay, next, 21 upon 63, 21 and 63, they are also divisible by 21. Both 21 and 63 are divisible by 21. If you know the table of 21, 21 ones are 21, 21 threes are 63. Okay, next, 9 upon 45, both 9 and 45 are divisible by 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 fives are 45. And 27 upon 36. Now see, 27 upon 36, both 27 and 36 are divisible by? Not by 27. They are divisible by 9. 9 threes are 27 and 9 fours are 36. Okay, so 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 5 and 3 by 4. Understood? Now here again, if you will see these fractions, these three fractions, first three fractions have same numerator. So here we can find smallest fraction of out of these three, but this fourth one fraction has numerator 3. Okay, so first what we will do, first we will find smallest fraction out of these. As we have to find smallest fraction out of these four, so what we will do, first we will find smallest fraction out of these three. Out of these three, which is smallest one? The fraction, when numerators are same, the fraction having greatest denominator is the smallest fraction. That means 1 by 5 smallest out of this 4, sorry, out of these three fractions, 1 by 5 is the smallest, okay? So, I will write here 1 by 5 and 3 by 4 again I will take here. So, now we have to compare these two fractions. Out of 1 by 5 and 3 by 4, which is small, the smallest? That will be the smallest fraction out of these 4. So, now how to compare these two fractions? Their numerators are not same and denominators are also not same. In that case, how to compare? There is one method. Which is that method? Method of cross multiplication. The method which we have used to check the equivalency of fraction. If you remember, the method which we have used to check equivalency of fraction, cross multiplication method, same method we will use. This way to check which fraction is greater and which out of these. So here, see, 4, 1 into 4 and 5 into 3. 4 ones are 4 and 5 threes are 15. So which side, here when we multiply this numerator and this denominator, that is 1 into 4, we got 4 here. And we, when we multiply this numerator and this denominator, we got 15. So this side multiplication, the multiplication on the right hand side is greater, right? This 15 is greater. That means if you, this side fraction is greater, that is 3 by 4 is, means 1 by 5 is less than 3 by 4. Okay, so which is the smallest here? 1 by 5 only. So at the end, 1 by 5 is the smallest. Understood what we have done? See here, first again I will explain you. These are the initial fractions, given fractions. Their numerators and denominators are not same. So what we have done, we found their reduced form. We convert them into reduced form. In this way, so we got 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 5 and 3 by 4. Here also all four fractions don't have same denominator or same numerator. So what we done, these three fractions have same numerator. So first we compare these three. So in these three fractions, 1 by 5 we got smallest. So we wrote 1 by 5 here and this 3 by 4 which was remain, we took here. Then we compare this 1 by 5 and 3 by 4. By which method we compare? Cross multiplication method. 1 into 4 and 3 into 5. Okay? While comparing these, see, you have to take first numerator of first fraction and denominator of second fraction on this side, and numerator of second fraction and denominator of first fraction we have to take in on the right side, okay? And then you have to multiply. Then we multiplied, we got here 4 and here 15. Okay, so 4 is smaller than 15. That means this side fraction is smaller than this side fraction. That is 1 by 5 is smaller than 3 by 4. Okay, so at the end we got which fraction we got smallest? 1 by 5. So 1 by 5 is smallest out of this 4. Understood? This is the another method which we are going to use to compare two fractions when their numerators and denominators are completely different. Okay? Now pause this video and write in your notebook. Okay, pause for some time. Fine. After this, we'll see next questions. Question number 4. See question number 4. If the fractions 3/5, 3/17, 3/13 or 3/13, 3/7 and 3/11 are arranged in an ascending order. If these fractions are arranged in ascending order, smallest to biggest, by how much is the third fraction less than 1? By how much is the third fraction less than 1? Okay, so first what we'll do, we will arrange these fractions into ascending order, smallest to biggest. Now here in this fraction, their numerators are same. Numerators are same. So when numerators are same and we have to arrange in ascending order, that means we have to find first smallest one. So when numerators are same, the fraction having greatest denominator is the smallest fraction. So this will come in the first position. Then there is 13. This will come in the second position, third position, fourth, and 3/5 is the highest, greatest fraction among these. Okay? So first one is 3/17, 3/13, 3/11, 3/7, and 3/5. Now what is the question? By how much the third fraction, this third one fraction, is smaller than or less than 1? By how much this 3/11 is less than 1? Okay, so third fraction is, third fraction is 3/11. So we have to compare now 3/11 and 1. Means what? 3/11 is less than 1. 3/11 is smaller than 1. 1 means one whole, okay? And 3/11 is a fractional number, that means it is obviously less than 1, smaller than 1. So we have to find that what is difference between 1 and 3/11. Okay, then only we will get by how much 3/11 is smaller than 1. So here we have to find difference, that means we need to do the subtraction. But the thing is, we have not learned subtraction of fraction yet. We are going to use another method. Which is that method? Very easy method. We have used it already. The fraction is 3/11. Now you know that 1 means one whole. Okay? So one whole means one whole. Suppose this is one chocolate. Fine? One whole means one chocolate. And now here fraction is 3/11. That means the 11 indicates total equal parts. So what we are going to do? We will divide the chocolate into 11 equal parts. Nine, ten, and eleven. So from here to here, consider it is one whole chocolate, one whole. Okay? And that one whole is divided into 11 parts. Out of 11, here this fraction indicates 3. 3 parts are shaded. Okay? Understood? This is one whole. See, we have to find difference means what? 1 minus 3/11. From 1, we have to subtract 3/11. Then what we will get? So this was one whole. Okay, then what we have done, this one whole we divided into 11 parts and 3 parts we have shaded. Okay, 3 parts we have shaded, that is 3/11. So if 3 upon 11 is subtracted from one whole, how many parts are remain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Out of 11 equal parts, 3 are shaded, that means 8 parts are remain. So 1 minus 3 upon 11, what remains? 8 upon 11. Understood? Once again, see here, this 1 means one whole. Okay? From one whole, we have to subtract 3 upon 11. Okay, and you know the meaning of 3 upon 11? This denominator, in the denominator there is 11, which indicates the total equal parts. So this one whole we divided into 11 parts, and this 3 indicates shaded part. So we have shaded this 3. Okay, so from this one whole, or out of this 11 parts, 3 parts are shaded. 3 upon 11 parts are shaded. So shaded parts represent 3 upon 11, and this, the parts which are not shaded, that indicates remaining parts. Okay, so out of 11, 8 are unshaded, that is 8 upon 11 are unshaded. Okay, so from 1, when you will subtract 3 11th, it remains 8 11th. 8 upon 11 is the answer. This is the very easy method. Actual subtraction method is different, that we will learn afterwards. Okay, when we will learn the subtraction of a fraction. So now this method, keep it in mind, it's very easy. And this method will clear this concept more deeply, okay? The next answer is 8 upon 11. Question number 5. If the fractions 15 upon 29, 15 upon 62, 15 upon 65, 15 upon 9 and 15 upon 8 are arranged in an descending order, biggest to smallest order, by which of them would be the middle one? So first we have to arrange them into descending order, biggest to smallest. Here also numerators are same, not denominator, numerators are same. In that case, the fraction having smallest denominator is the greatest fraction. So here, which is the fraction having smallest denominator? 8. 15 upon 8 is the greatest. Descending order. 15 upon 8, then 15 upon 9, 15 upon 29, 15 upon 62, and 15 upon 65. The fraction having greatest denominator is smallest fraction. 15 upon 65 is the smallest among these. Okay? Now see, in these 5, which is middle one? We have to find middle one. So 15 upon 29 is the middle one. Okay? Next, sixth one, pay attention carefully, this is very important question. Put your finger when I am reading. A container was filled with 6 kilogram of rice, 6 kg of rice. The level of rice was up to 2/3 of the total height of the container. How much rice should be filled in to make the container full? Okay, container means what? The what we can say, the pot in which we keep the rice, container. So if it is like this container, for example, I'm showing you. Okay, now it is, in this container, how much rice is there? 6 kilogram rice, 6 kg rice is there now, currently, okay? The level of rice was up to 2/3 of the total height of the container. So this is from here to here, this is total height of the container. And the rice which was there, it was up to height of 2/3. 2/3 means what? The container is divided into total 3 equal parts. Let us divide. okay, two, three equal parts, and see the level of rice, means 6 kg rice was there, no? The level of that rice was 2/3 of the container, total height. So out of three equal parts, two parts were filled. Up till here, okay, the rice was there in that container. So 2/3 of the part means how much kg rice was there? 6 kg. There was 6 kg rice filled in the container, and it was 2/3 of the container, total height of the container, okay. So two parts means 6 kg. See here, two parts, okay, wait, two parts means 6 kg rice, correct? Then one part means how many? 2 parts means 6 kg rice, then 1 part means how many kg rice? 6 divided by 2 kg, that is 3 kg rice. 1 part means 3 kg rice, correct? Okay, so 3, 3, 6. Then the question is, how much rice should be filled in this container? Again, how much rice should be filled so that the container will become full? So out of three parts, two parts are filled and one part remain, and each one part contains 3 kg rice. That means how much more rice should be filled in this? 3 kg. How much? 3 kg rice. So 3 kg more rice should be filled to make the container full. To make the container full. Understood? Now pause this video and write this in your notebook. After that, we will see next questions. Okay? Next, question number 7. Ten questions we are going to see in this lecture. Question number 7. See here. 21. It's not working. 21 upon 18 minus 7 upon 18 plus 5 upon 18 is equal to how much? Is equal to how much? Okay, so here there is subtraction and addition of the fraction. Now pay attention very carefully. This addition and subtraction of fraction we have learned in previous class, but there was only the subtraction and addition of like fraction. Now what is mean by this like fraction? The like fraction means the fractions having same denominator. So are here same denominator in these fractions? Yes. See now, 18, 18, 18, same denominator, means all these three fractions are like fractions. So addition and subtraction of like fraction is very easy. Now see, there are two operations, subtraction and addition. Then do you remember Bodmas rule? Which operation we have to do first? Addition, okay? So see here, we will add. Again see, this in front of this 7 upon 18, there is minus sign, so this will keep separate. We will add first 21 upon 18 plus 5 upon 18, and this will keep separate. Let's add this first. So when we are going to add two like fractions, how to add? We have to add only numerator. Denominator take common, and we have to add only numerator, that is 21 plus 5. If you remember, we have to add only numerator, okay? Minus 7 upon 18 as it is, take down, is equal to 21 plus 5, 26 upon 18 minus 7 upon 18. Now there is only subtraction. Subtraction of like fraction is also same. when we are going to add fractions, their denominator must be same. Their denominators must be same. Here, as here there are 18, 18. Denominators are same. Okay? And in the fraction, addition and subtraction of fraction, we add or subtract only numerators. But when we can add and subtract only numerators? When their denominators are same. Okay, here denominators are same, so we are directly subtracting or adding these numerators. But when denominators will not be same, in that case what to do? Okay, that we are going to learn afterwards. Now see, here denominators are same, take denominator common and subtract only numerator, 26 minus 7. So 26 minus 7 is 19. Okay, 19 upon 18 is the answer. 19 upon 18. So 21 upon 18 minus 7 upon 18 plus 5 upon 18 is 19 upon 18. Understood? Next, 8th one. See, find the most reduced form of 5 plus 14 plus 3 upon 14 minus 1 upon 14. So, first we have to complete these operations, plus and minus, and then whatever answer we will get in this way. We have to find reduced form of that. Okay? So, first let's add these. These are also like fraction. Their denominators are same. So, these are also like fraction. Okay? So, this is in front of 1 upon 14, there is minus sign. So, we'll keep it separate. Let's add these. Denominator take common and add numerators, minus 1 upon 14. 5 plus 3, 8 upon 14, minus 1 upon 14. Okay, addition over, now subtraction. Again, same denominator take common, 8 minus 1. 8 minus 1 is 7 upon 14. Now, answer is 7 upon 14. But again, this fraction 7 upon 14, we can convert into reduced form, smallest term. So think that both 7 and 14 are divisible by which same number? Are they divisible by 7? Both? Yeah. 7 divided by 7. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 1 by 2 is the reduced form of 7 upon 14. Understood? So this is our answer, 1 by 2. Addition of like, addition and subtraction of like fraction is very easy. Now see ninth one. If 3/4 of a number is 75, this is quite complicated question. Pay attention very carefully. Pause this video for some time, take rest of 1 or 2 minutes and then see this question, okay? If 3/4 of a number is 75, by how much is the number greater than 75? Okay. So that number whose 3/4 is 75, that number is by how much greater than 75? That we have to find. Okay. See here, 3/4 of a number. Now, addition and subtraction will not go to that method. By that method, we will go by figurical representation. 3/4. Our fraction is 3/4, okay? 3/4 of a number. So, a number means we will consider this one. This is a number, okay? X. And 3/4 of it is 75. Means what? If that number is divided into 4 equal parts, if that number is divided into 4 equal parts and 3 parts are shaded, its 3 parts means 75. Its 3 parts means 75. So see, 3 parts means 75. Then one part means how much?
Can you guess? 75 divided by 3. That is 25. One part means 25. 25, 25, 25, 25. So this one more part also
25. So total this number means how much? 25.
So 4 parts is equal to
4 parts means complete a number. That number is equal to 25 into 4. That is 100. So that a number means whole number is 100. Okay. Now we have to find that by how much is the number, this number greater than 75. Means this 100 is by how much greater than 75. So we to find that we need to subtract 75 from 100. So 100 minus 75 is 25, correct? So 100 is greater than 75. By 25. Okay, figurical representation, if you understand, that means you understand the concept, then the method which will apply afterwards, those methods you will understand very easily and quickly. Okay, now pause this video and write this. One more question is there that we will solve today, question number 10. Question number 10 is, by how much is the expression 12 upon 17 minus 15 upon 17 plus 13 upon 17 less than 1? Less than 1 means we have to compare the answer of this with the 1. Okay, that we will do afterwards. First we will do the addition. There is minus and plus two operations, so minus will write in the last. Okay, 12 upon 17 plus 13 upon 17 and minus 15 upon 17. Here also all fractions are like fractions, their denominators are same, so we can add or subtract the numerators. Let's do addition first. Take numerator denominator common, 12 plus 13 and minus 15 upon 17. 13 plus 12, 25 upon 17 minus 15 upon 17. Now only subtraction, take denominator common, 25 minus 15. So 25 minus 15 is 10 upon 17. Okay. Now this 10 upon 17 is how much less than 1? Obviously, this is fractional number 10 upon 17, that means it is less than 1, but by how much? So if you see this fraction 10 upon 17, 1 means what? 1 means what? 1 whole. Okay? And it is divided into 17 parts. 1 minus 10 upon 17 we have to do. Okay? So this is 1 whole and it is divided into, suppose, 17 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. Okay. This is one whole. It is divided into 17 equal parts and out of 17, 10 are shaded. 10 are 1. Okay, not this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, 10 are shaded. Then how much that 1 whole is remain? Out of 17 equal parts, 10 parts are remain. So how many parts remain? 7. Upon 17. 7 parts out of 17 are remain. So 1 minus 10 upon 17 is 7 upon 17. So by 7 upon 17, this 10 upon 17 is less than 1. Okay?
This is our answer.
Understood? So today we have seen the first 10 questions of the exercise 8. If you have any doubt in this, watch this video twice. And again, if you have doubt in this, you can ask me. Okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.